So first of all, I'd like to ask you.
Cybercrimes requires us to work with non-police entities. So we need international multidisciplinary alliance to fight cybercrime. The police had suffered from under-reporting. So police does not have, law enforcement does not have complete picture, complete understanding of the threat we face. So in order for us to effectively, efficiently to deal with this threat, we need to work together.
First event. The internet will change.
And you know, EC3 is only a regional component for Europe, but we cannot do this even in Europe alone. That's why we need to reach out to other countries, because in the future, I will guess that when Africa comes online, and it's booming Africa like this, we will see much more crime from Africa towards other regions, and they will also themselves be a victim of crime. And again, because we know this, we have to prepare the African states for that fact when they go online, and that is why we have capacity building programs together with Interpol in that area. Nation states do activities against each other. They spy, they prepare for war, they do a lot of things. They have done this always also before the internet. They continue on the internet. This is something that intelligence organizations deal with, and this is not what we do. What we do is we take the normal criminals who does normal crime towards normal citizens, and then we try to focus on this. Yeah. And this is very, very important, because the other thing will distract us, because if politics starts here, then we cannot fight crime. And I need to work with China, with Russia, and with everybody to fight crime at the internet.
Private sectors, internet security companies, or internet companies, they have huge resources, huge information for us to fight against cybercrime. So we are going to fuse information to produce actionable intelligence for our member countries' actions, which is investigation or prevention or detection of cybercrime.